In his letter to the Speaker of the House and the President of the Senate, dated 30th October 2023, the U.S. President Joe Biden has revealed plans to expel Uganda, Gabon, Niger, and the Central African Republic from a special U.S.-Africa trade program named AGOA on accounts of gross violations of human rights and not making progress towards democratic rule. This has sparked anxiety from legislators.
For the shocks, the United States government has indicated their plans to remove Uganda from the AGOA trade deal. I do not know whether the minister is aware of this, and if you are aware, what measures, if you are aware, the US has indicated that they're going to remove us from the AGOA deal. You are aware, and if you are aware, Mr. Minister, sir, what measures are being undertaken by our government?
So for me, I don't look at AGOA for its own sake. You look at the statement. What does America, what statement is America making in broad terms? And it's a big threat in governments where you are highly dependent on donor money to run your budget, because half of our budget is not locally funded.
However, while meeting the Parliamentary Committee of National Economy, the Executive Director of the Uganda Bureau of Statistics, Dr. Chris Mukiza, noted that Uganda shouldn't lose sleep for losing AGOA market because it has not been fetching much for the country.
Yes, well, as AGOA sounds well, the country has not earned enough the foreign exchange that we thought would get. Last financial is when we got some spike of about $84 million the whole year. When you compare to ESC and COMESA and India, those are our biggest exporting countries where we export our commodities.
Uganda has exported goods worth $377 million to the United States market in the last five financial years, with textile being the top exported commodity according to UBUS, with only $87.7 million of goods exported to the U.S. in the last financial year, 2022-2023. Mukiza says Uganda should concentrate on the African market, which fetches more foreign exchange. However, the Minister of State for Trade, Harriet Ntabazi, says Uganda can't afford to lose the U.S. market. She has vowed to exploit all avenues to renegotiate the agreement. Ntabazi has expressed disappointment with the U.S. for mixing trade with human rights, which according to her are parallel.
Because what we are looking at now, we as the Minister of Trade, is the trade of these two countries. It is not good to mix trade with human rights.
Meanwhile, the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, told the Committee of National Economy that Uganda is making positive strides in negotiation with the World Bank on the sanctions which were imposed on the country following the passing of the anti-homosexuality law.
We are involved in heavy negotiations with the World Bank, and we have made significant progress. There are a number of benchmarks they have given us to do, and there is information they have asked us to provide, and also evidence that certain things what they were querying would be addressed.
The current AGOA agreement is expiring in 2025, and African countries under the program are converging in South Africa to renegotiate the pact. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.